Hi everyone, and welcome to another Tech Saturday with Eric and Keith. Alright guys, so today we're going to talk about the Corsair IQ software.
What's that again?
It's a software for Corsair that controls all of your peripherals inside your case, like your fans, your RGB memory, or your AIO water cooler. And you guys remember we had a whole bunch of fun with this when we set up Eric's computer. But they watched that video, right? They watched that. If not, we'll link it up here.
Click the like button if you watch that.
Yes, 100%. So the software, you can set it up to turn your fans different colors, your memory different colors, do different actions, and it syncs the whole system up, you know, as one versus individual, you know, like software to control your fans, your RGB strips or whatever.
Okay, well that's cool. If you're into like building your own PC, you're looking like maybe you're gonna, you know, put some RGB stuff in it or whatever, definitely wanna stick around for this one. And it's super simple. We'll show you how.
But before we get too deep, I just wanna say something. Did you fail again with a t-shirt?
Oh man, I'm not repping the merch.
See, he should be repping the merch, but again.
Didn't you have that one trick thing that fixed that?
We installed the snap feature.
Yeah, that snap feature, that's what it was.
Okay, here we go.
Much better.
Look at that.
Yeah.
Yes, that's awesome.
So much more comfy.
Ooh, I know.
Soft and comfy,
yeah,
right?
Yeah. All right, guys, well, let's get into it. Roll that intro. Alright guys, well before we get too far into this, recently we joined into the SkillShare affiliate program, and so I want to give a shout out to them. If you don't know already, SkillShare is a place where you can go learn from different experts in different fields like photography, videography, technology, you know, there's like a wide range of things you can learn from them. I myself am taking a Premiere Pro class to, you know, try to up my video editing skills or whatever, but it's really cool because they have like a range from like beginners to experts, so anywhere in there, you know, if you're just learning or if you're really good at it and you just want to polish your skills a little bit more, they have all that there for you.
Okay, so where can they find that? Where are we going to put the link?
Well, we'll drop the link so they can find it down in the description here below.
Okay.
And then if they use our link, they get 2 free months.
Awesome, that'd be great.
I know, so it's like a risk-free type of thing. Just sign up, 2 free months.
Yeah, and you help the channel out if you sign up too.
Yep, you do help the channel out, so it's like you help the channel out, you help yourself out, so it's kind of a win-win, and we're super excited to bring this to you guys.
Alright guys, so let's get to the IQ software here.
Oh yeah,
the reason they clicked this
video. I know, the reason they clicked this, totally. we're here for you guys. First we're going to give you like a little overview of Eric's computer, show you like what he's got going on. You know, he's got sort of a cool little thing. What do you got going on with your RGB right now?
Well, you know, like it's the holiday season, so
it
I figured set up holiday colors. So
right.
That's what I did, kind of green and red and white RGB colors going on in my case. We'll show you in a second.
So we'll show you that. So that's what we're going to be changing and messing around with. And then we'll jump over to the computer and probably do like a screen share,
yeah,
screen record, something like that. Because it'll probably be easier for them to see, I would think. And then show you how to do all that. All right, let's check out the RGB.
All right, guys, and here's Eric's awesome computer. If you guys remember building that, he's added another fan to it too, so it's extra awesome. But go ahead and show what we got in here.
Okay, so yeah, we have the Corsair light loop fans that are down here on the side, and then you can't see, but there's 3 up top. And then we have Corsair memory, and then a Corsair AIO, which is our water cooling for our CPU. And so the other LEDs you see in there in the back here are just the motherboard built-in RGB that's not controlled by the Corsair software. So we're only going to be dealing with the fans, the memory, and the AIO today.
All right, let's jump into the computer and check some stuff out.
Okay, guys, so we're on my desktop. I mean, what do you think of that desktop background? That's pretty sweet.
Huh? Awesome.
Okay, so we're going to deal with the IQ software right here. So we're going to double-click that.
it brings you to the dashboard, and you can see that you have a home, which shows all your connected devices. So I have a RGB keyboard, mouse pad, even your AIO water cooler, your Vengeance RGB memory, your Commander, and I have two Commander Pros. These both control the fans and the RGB lighting. You see my profile I have set up here. If I go to the home here, I have Eric's winter profile set up. So, and then I have a Eric's fall set up. What that is I just set all my memory up. So if we click into, we'll just do memory first. And then we go into here and we'll do lighting effects. You can see that I did a multicolor as my my colors. And for my colors, I chose red, green, white. So alternating back and forth, red, green, white on the dim slots. So you can see this is what it's going to look like. So it kind of looks like a very Christmassy, right?
Very Christmassy, yes.
And so I set that up just by choosing multicolor in here in the drop down. You also have different options. You can do like spiral rainbow, and you can kind of see that it does like you can't really, it's just doing a like downward rainbow. You do clockwise, counterclockwise, go up or down. So it's pretty easy to configure however you want your lighting effects to look like. And same with your AIO, you just go in here, it's on lighting effects already. You have color shift, and I just chose green and red as my two colors. I just chose from these colors down here, but if you click on this, you could drag around and create like whatever color you want.
So it's really customizable.
Yeah, but, I mean, you can do a whole bunch of customization with this. You know, seasonally, I think, like, you know, I had a Halloween one, which is pretty cool too. So like, you, if the Commander Pro's here, you see that lighting setup. I don't have any devices on this one, but on this one, if I go here, both the lighting channels are plugged into this one. So all of my fans that have RGB light on them are plugged into the Commander Pro, so I can control them with this one device. And you can kind of see what it's doing right here. It shows a neat little animation of the Pong thing that it's doing. You see it's called Pong, and I just chose my fan color is, you know, green, which is the background color. The paddle color is white. So like when it gets over to the end, you can kind of see it change here, and then you can see it change here. So it's bouncing the ball back and forth, basically.
Right, yeah.
So, and then the ball I just made red, so you can kind of see a good contrast in between both going back and forth. And then on lighting channel 2, which is just the top lights, instead of making it green all the way around, I kind of made it like, I like the white look, because it kind of makes it look like it's snowing a little bit, you know.
Yeah, that is neat.
It's pretty easy to set up like that. In here, there's also performance setup. You can see the fans where I have like these different, I guess, the profiles created for my fans. So, you know, right now it's a custom curve. I don't want it to get above 1400 and whatever RPMs at this temperature. So you can drag these temperature around if you want to, spots around to change the how fast your fans are spinning. You see right now they're all spinning at about 950 RPM. You can set it as fixed RPMs, and here to 950. And then set your rad temps. You know, this is in cooling mode, so you can see cooling fixed RPM is 950 on all fans. You know, if you had three fans, like 1, 2, and 3 here, are the bottom 4, 5, 6 are like pushing out my rad, so my radiator. So if you wanted to just maybe up these, if your temperatures are looking a little hot, if you come over here and you see your temps are kind of going up, you know, they're resting in the mid 30s and you want them down in the 20s, you know, at idle, then you can just come in there and like bump those fans up so it moves more air across that.
It's, yeah, that's helpful. I mean, you know, because like you do a little overclocking type thing situation, yeah, and stuff like that, and having the ability just to adjust your fans like this, yet still keep it as quiet as it is, because I don't know if you guys could hear in the background, it's just a very low light hum right now for the fans, and that's pretty impressive for all those fans that we have in that case over there.
Yeah, you can see also, I have my keyboard here, and I like the animations. Corsair did a really good job on the animations.
Yeah, I mean, it helps you visualize it and see what you're getting into.
Right, and I mean, you know, you choose rainbow wave. If you're like, well, I don't know, what's spiral rainbow do? Well, it kind of, it spins it around, and if you can't really see the keyboard right now, but it's doing the same thing, so it's mimicking what this is doing, but it's really neat that the software does that. The rain's kind of cool, and then you can slow it down if that's going too fast for you.
This is some neat software.
So yeah, Corsair used to have two different softwares where you can controlled the fan speed and stuff like that with one, and then you controlled the RGB software with the, or the fan curve with another. This IQ software, you know, the dashboard, you can see like your whole system basically.
Yeah, one snapshot without having to open up a whole bunch of different apps. That's super handy.
Right. I really like this software. It's very customizable. If you like tech stuff and you like customizing your computer to your taste, this is definitely the way to go.
Definitely.
Okay, guys, so I hope you liked that little demonstration of the Corsair IQ software. Maybe you got a little ideas on how to set your own RGB setup up.
I know, that was awesome, and it was super easy. It's not that challenging, you know, I don't think.
Nope, not really.
Just play around with it, you know, mess around with it. You can do all kinds of different things. We weren't going to go through every single customization you can do, because there's a ton of
you can do a bunch.
But it's definitely well worth it if you're thinking about building your own PC, and you want to add some RGB to it. Definitely check out Corsair. All right, everyone. Well, thanks a lot for watching again. Don't forget to drop a like, share this video, and drop a comment down below. Tell us what you thought of it. Tell us if you use the Skillshare link and what you thought about that too. Interesting to know how many of you guys were thinking about signing up for the Skillshare. And don't forget, we got the sweet merch still out there, so check those links out below. All right, guys. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thanks a lot for watching, guys. Peace and love.
This is gonna be hard. There's lots of words.
No, that's why I'm glad you're doing it.
Words. Big words. Dance party.
That's in the blooper.
I can't dance. Okay. It's bad. It's scary.
Alright, guys, well, before we go to.
I myself am currently taking. I can't even say the word premiere. Why is that not coming out of my mouth when I'm talking?
Just wet your lips.
There you go.
Definitely. Premiere. Definitely have a blooper.